Hello and welcome to Red Stapler channel. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a parallax scrolling effect that makes the element appears that they are scrolling at a different speed, with a bonus code that I've combined this with an animated snow background from previous tutorial to create a stunning effect for your website. Ready? Let's check it out. Let's talk about the key concept that creates the parallax first. The parallax is the effect that the object in the distance appears to move more slowly than the object close to the eye. So based on this, if we create two dips with one of them pushed into the back for some distance, we'll also see the parallax effect when scrolling through the website. Let's create two wrapper dips. One for parallax and one for regular. Also added some content inside too. For the CSS, first, I'm going to set our width and height to 100% of the viewport and added some padding and background for our aesthetic purpose. I set the box sizing to border box. This will include the padding into the width and height and make our wrapper size exactly at 100% of the viewport. And next I'm going to add a pseudo element to the parallax wrapper. This element will be served as a background, so we are going to add a transform to it later. But for now let's set the size, position and background image first. Adding position absolute is important, since we want this element to be in background and out of the way for the content. Let's add the background image to the regular wrapper too. Okay, the structure is complete. Let's work on the parallax. First, set the overflow hidden to root element and height of the body to 100% of the viewport. This is to fix the viewing area. Then add a perspective to instruct the browser to display in 3D perspective mode. Also add a preserved 3D transform style to the body and the parallax wrapper. And next, set overflow X to hidden and overflow Y to auto. This because we are working in 3D mode and we do not want the horizontal scroll bar to appear for the off-screen content. Next, we are going to push the background div to the back by adding translate C for -1 pixel. By adding this, the distance between the viewing area and this element becomes farther. As a result, you will see this dip smaller. Since we set the perspective value to 1 pixel and we also move the dip back for 1 pixel, you will see the dip at half of the original size. To counter this, we will scale the dip by 2 times. Almost complete. Now you will see that the regular dip is being overlaid by the parallax. We can fix this by setting the C-index of the parallax wrapper to negative and regular to positive. Since C-index only works on position element, I'm going to also add position relative to the regular wrapper. And here's the result. Now adding more content is very easy. You can just duplicate both wrappers and it's done. With this concept, you can combine it with any CSS background effect that you like to create an awesome user experience. For example, here is the combination of the parallax effect with the snow from our previous tutorial. You can find all the links at the description box below. So, that's all for this tutorial. If you love it, as always, please don't forget to like or subscribe to support us. Thanks for watching and see you on next upload. Bye!